College of Engineering students, I also want to welcome you back to our rooms. There's going to be differences in rooms that you're going to see. So here I am in Feed the Learning Commons, and you're used to using these computer stations behind me, but some of those are closed off. Those ones that are closed off are used for remote learning, but you can sit at those other ones, and we're going to have cleaning procedures for that. But in addition, we've made a classroom in this space that we're going to look at here in just a little bit. In some of the earlier messages, I told you that some of your classrooms had a lot less capacity. Well, what we had to do was take Feed the Learning Commons and make this a classroom that you see behind me here. This will hold 48 of you. Some of you are going to take classes in here, and some of you are going to take exams in here. But you're also going to notice that those tables that you used for your studying and group projects, they're all being used in the classroom right now. So we're going to have some of those tables out in the atrium space for you, with a variety of chairs and social distancing markings for you to use. Here's another room that you're familiar with, Fiedler Auditorium, or DUF 1107. This room is only allowed to have 42 people. Normally it has 145 to 150, but there's also limited seating, and you're going to see stickers at each of the spots where you can sit. So if there's not a sticker, you can't sit there. You're also going to see in this room that some of these rows have 3 seats, and there's some rows that have 1. But that's because we had to make the spacing work with the configuration of the room. So each room is going to be a little bit different, but the seats that you can sit at will be identified with a sticker. So here we are in DUE 1112, or the Collaborative Learning Labs for SAS. Now, a lot of you are very familiar with SAS and have used SAS, and last spring we had to go to 100% online. This fall it's going to be a mix. Some of our SAS tutoring will be online, but we're also going to have face-to-face. And for example, behind me here, we've got plexiglass shields that'll be used for some of the face-to-face SAS tutoring exercises. But it's going to be spread around in different parts of the building because we had to take part of the SAS room. As you see these partitions, we have a 26-person classroom that's going to be on the other side of that wall. Your study rooms are going to be a little bit different. This one behind me is limited to 2 people. Some may have 3 and some may have 4. We'll have signage on the outside to direct you to that. But you're also going to need to be responsible for cleaning that study room when you come into that room and when you leave the room. And we'll have some of those supplies available for you. Okay, so one of the other things you're going to see in your classrooms, we talked about how people are going to be socially distanced. Sometimes you'll see faculty wearing a face shield instead of a face mask. They're allowed to do this. It's a little easier to talk in a face shield, but they're going to need to wear their face mask when they go to and from the classroom. So we just talked about a lot of spaces, but the one space I didn't spend much time in was the atrium. So the atrium is going to be a little bit different. It will have those long banquet tables just like at the career fair, but they're there for you to study on. And that's because we had to take up space out of Feed the Learning Commons and the SAS room to use for classrooms and to space things out. And when you use those tables, you're going to need to keep them clean for you and for the next person. And while we're on clean, wear your masks all the time, wash your hands frequently, carry hand sanitizer with you and use that frequently, and we'll have hand sanitizer throughout this space. We look forward to you being back here. Have a great move-in time, and we'll see you soon.